All right, guys, I figured this video wasn't important enough to make despite me being sick, so forgive my voice. But basically, it was discovered that a whole bunch of Chrome extensions with millions of users have malicious code in them. They were either legitimate extensions that got hijacked, and I'll explain how that happened, or like the developers put sketchy code in them. Anyway, I'll put the full list on the screen here. So if you recognize any of these, you want to go uninstall them and then probably change your password specifically for Facebook, but maybe all of them. I'll explain why in a second. And actually, several of them were featured extensions, which makes it even scarier. And because Chrome extensions auto-update, if you have these extensions installed, no matter when you initially installed it, you were infected probably. Because what happened for most of these was that on Christmas Eve, actually, hackers sent out phishing emails to a whole bunch of Chrome extension developers using the support email on their Chrome extension page. Basically, it was some kind of thing that said, oh, your Chrome extension is in violation of some policy and click this link to log in and see. And then it effectively authorized an app that would have access to their developer account, and that would also bypass any two-factor authentication. And then the hackers, once they had access to that account, they went and modified the code in the extension and then pushed the update to the store, the Chrome Web Store. So anyone who had any of these extensions installed would then get auto-updated with the malicious code. There's one company called Extension Total that made a list of all of these that they found, including some extensions that had indicators of compromise from previous malware and malicious campaigns as well, so they made a complete list. I'll put that link in the description. Now, most of the recent ones from the December 25th attack have been either removed or fixed by the developers, but again, if you had them installed, then the code still would have been installed to you, so you still need to treat it as if you were infected, because you likely were, if it installed to you, auto-update. And like I said, what's even scarier is several of these extensions are featured extensions, meaning supposedly for a featured extension, the Chrome Web Store employees will actually hand review these extensions. Now, I guess they probably don't do this for every single update. It's probably one thing where, you know, once it's accepted as featured, then future updates are just not changing that. But still, it's kind of like you see that featured badge, you assume, well, it's more trustworthy. And again, these were legitimate, for the most part, extensions. It's just that their developer accounts got hijacked. If we look at what they actually changed, the hackers, for this one example, this Yes Captcha extension, which has been updated, it seems like, despite the extension total list showing it is not, I think they have updated this. Basically, in the background.js file in this code, they added an extra function to the bottom of the existing file. So it's not even like they purely just added a new code file. They actually edited the existing one. And actually, the hackers registered custom domains for a lot of these. So this one goes to like yescaptcha.pro. Do not go to this website, obviously, it's malicious. But they actually registered special domains to make it look even more legitimate within the code. And apparently what this function does is it fetches another file from that domain, and then it loads it into the Chrome local storage. And that one, which I don't have, would apparently like steal cookies and data from Facebook and try to hack into Facebook business accounts, something like that. Though I'm not 100% certain if they all did that, they might have also stolen other stuff. Now, some of the extensions on the list from Extension Total are from previous malicious campaigns or have other indicators of compromise. For example, this Where is Cookie one, it looks like this one was flagged because it has a known malicious URL that is used for like affiliate fraud or something like that, apparently, where it would like hijack the affiliate links and insert their affiliate link into websites you visit, even if it has nothing to do with this extension. So there's other extensions in there like that. So it seems like that was a case of not even the developer account being hijacked, but rather it was purposefully put in there, which is worse. So it's probably good to uninstall anything on this list if they show as not being updated. Although I will say, in my own checking, it does seem that the Yes Captcha and Parrot Talk extensions have been updated to remove the malicious code. So those two on the Extension Total site don't show as being updated, but I think they are. But again, if you had these installed at all, you need to make sure you reset the Facebook passwords at least. Anyway, I'd love to hear what you guys think. Like, if you had any of these extensions installed, what are you gonna do? We could talk about that down in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like this for the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about a stupid problem that my Logitech keyboard has and that I had to fix myself by creating my own app for it. So you might find that useful as well. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one, hopefully with my regular voice back.